His heart was pounding and his legs were aching, but there was no way this former Marine was going to drop the flag and let anyone down, especially a friend.
There was no doubts at first. A lot of prayers on the way. As I ran, you know, in that cold weather, without prepping, without running, prepping myself and stretching enough, your legs start to cramp, and every step is painful. But you know, yes, the Marine Corps did teach me to adapt and overcome certain situations. I've been in worse situations.
Max said he prayed a lot, and sure, he wanted to quit. Are you kidding? But he believed in the mission and supported the cause.
I did not want to put Max out. I didn't want to ask him to help. There was just no question he was going to help and stand behind the issue, and God love him. I couldn't have done it without him.
I know that the Marines taught me any soldier goes into battle as a loner goes home alone, and that means in a body bag.
Brad wasn't alone on this day, and neither were the veterans. Max had their back, and it's the stuff legends are made, or in this case, traditions born.
I really thought the day was over. I mean, here we are trying to establish the first annual Jefferson Veterans Day Run, and I thought the dream just ended. And I look out of the corner of my eye, and here's this guy without the proper running gear on, grabs the flag, jumps out in the rain, and just takes off, and without hesitation.
Hometown hero, in your opinion?
Absolutely, a hometown hero will always be a hometown hero.
The Marines' motto is Semper Fidelis, always faithful. Max Maxfield certainly was, is, and always will be.
And it was raining and it was cold, but that's nothing compared to what our veterans have had to endure in the past or have to endure over in Iraq, those situations. We didn't have bullets flying at us. Maybe a few cars every now and again.